Good morning, everyone. So this video I wanted to make because I've been asked, can you heat your house while you go to work with the wood stove? Yes. So this is how I used to do it, and I now currently work from home, so we don't like to have this on during the middle of the day pumping into it. And this week it's gonna be cold. Right now it's 5:07 and it's -4 out, so I got some coals in here. I loaded this, I think it was 8:30 or 9:15 last night. That's the last time I loaded it. Got some tips and tricks that'll help you get through the day if you have to go to work. And this is gonna be figured on if you're gone for like 10 hours. What I do, open up the air, crack the door, let the air go through for a little bit. Grab my ash bucket, and you can see, you see how it's not really dirty around here? So last time I cleaned all this was on Thursday, and it currently is Monday. What I do is I come in, I have a little lip up here, and I always take that, just that little bit of ash off. And it, I found by doing little bits of it, you're gonna have not much buildup at all. So then I come out to the sides, and you just go in just a little bit, and you're gonna find you're not gonna grab any of the ash. All of this, you're gonna move it around, because you want it to go and get really hot. Bring all your coals up front. Now we're just gonna crack the door, push that out of the way. We're gonna let it get really hot for a little bit here. Now when you have that, doing that, you can fill up your water. I always do a pot up here. We did two for a while. One we found is just fine. Just helps bring moisture in the air around here. And once in a while we throw like cinnamon sticks in there. Just realize you guys probably have a hard time hearing me with that fan on, so I shut it off. Grab some scrap wood. Now, see how it's really red hot? Really, you can feel it coming out. You probably can't, I can. We're gonna throw some of the scrap in there. Crack the door again. Now the fire's going good. Door's cracked. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna close it. You want all that heat to go up right away to get this warm, the whole top, because that's where all the tubes are. You want your tubes and everything to be warm up here, and you want the flue to be drawing really good. You can see it took off right away. You can use any kind of kindling with this. This is what I do. This has worked for me all the time. And this is where you can go and brush your teeth and come back, deodorant on, whatever you gotta do your morning. And then time you come back, this will be burnt down a little bit, and then I'll show you what we do next. All right, teeth are brushed. Smell my breath. Now, I have some wood here. What I do is I fill this up every day. And by filling it up every day, this is generally what I have left in the morning. So this is all I need to get going. And then once we load this, then I'll show you what we do, how I keep everything really clean so you're not having a dirty mess. Everyone says wood stoves are just messy as heck, and it's on how you do things. So if you're gonna be messy about it, it's gonna be messy. If you're gonna be clean about it, it's gonna be clean. Now the other thing is, have a glove or something for your loading hand, because it's gonna be hot. What we're gonna do is we're gonna take the wood. Now I'm gonna take this and go, they call this east to west loading. This is north to south. Doesn't matter actually how your stove is facing. Just think of it that way. Looking at your stove is north to south, and then you got east and west. We're gonna load everything this way, and I'll explain why in a minute. Now I'm gonna crack the door and just leave it cracked. There's lips on here, so none of this stuff falls out. That's one reason why I picked this one. So now it is 5:21. -6 out. Oof. You want to get this flaming, so you're gonna have to sit here for just a little bit. Once it gets flaming, then we'll shut it down, shut the door, and go from there. As far as tricks on keeping this clean, what I do, what I've found, because I've had this, we've had this now for over 8 years. What I've found is we take the wood when we're outside, every time we grab a piece, we take the end of it and we bang it on the ground before I put it in the bag. So we don't have a huge mess in here. And I found by doing that, it saves me so much work in here because it's way easier to start up the leaf blower and blow off the patio. And I'll show you my whole setup out there right here. That's, we found it's the easiest. It keeps all the dirt out there and all the mess, and it keeps it nice and clean in here. So now it's going pretty good. I'm gonna take it and just shut it. Because now it's gonna heat up the tubes again. When you have the door open like that, it wants to go straight up and out, and it's just gonna heat up your flue, which and therefore will have a nice draw. But now we know that this is lit on fire really well. It's gonna start heating up the tubes, and then you're gonna start seeing the secondary burns go. And currently the stove is running at 200 degrees. So can you see the top tubes up there? You can see they're starting to burn. And they have flames, it looks like it's coming out. That's where there's fresh air coming in, and it's burning the smoke. So it's burning, it's recycling and burning all the smoke, and that's where you get a ton of your heat from these new stoves. They're so more efficient. That's why you want dry wood also. You want under 20%. Now it's starting to climb. So now you can hear the stove pinging and tanging, creaking, making all sorts of noise. It's all warming up. Now we're approaching the 300, and if you're listening to your stove, you can hear, it's like my air intake is right here, and that's what this slide is, but you can hear it just sucking air really hard. So what we want to do before this gets too high, you're going to take this, you're going to put it right where you want it. Okay, so mine is closed all the way and open. It's probably about an eighth to 3/16 open on this stove. This is different to every stove. But I've found by running it like this, I'll get, the stove will be up, it'll go around 500 to 550 sometimes, but generally about 500, and it'll cruise there for a very long time. But before it gets there, it'll take time to get caught up burning this way, but it'll stay up in the clean burn area, and it'll stay over 400 for quite a long time. Like I said, used to do this before I'd go to work every day. Now, I work from home. I work in there, my wife works here. Let's see, a 10-hour day. Let's say I leave at 6 o'clock because I was up at 5. I would get home at 4. So, I'll bring this back on at 4 o'clock. When I take lunch break, I'll come and I'll walk you through. We'll look at the stove. I won't touch the dampener, nothing, and then we'll do it again at 4 o'clock as like you were home from work. Now I know someone's gonna ask, well, how much wood do you go through in a year? Last year was a really long winter for us and it went late, and we went through under 3 cord. It was close to 3 cord, but it was under 3 cord. This is 2100 square feet house. It was built in the 60s and it's 2x4 frame construction. So, and it was a moved in house. 3 cord to heat this whole house, I think it's pretty darn good. We're located in Minnesota, central Minnesota, so it gets cold here. Like I said, it's -4 right now. 11:27, 9 degrees out. The stove is at 200, or it's about 290. And this is what we have, what it looks like on the inside. Now remember, I'm not gonna touch anything until 4 o'clock. So, see you at 4. All right, it's 4 o'clock, and the stove temp is, I would say about 190, 185, 190. So let's get her going. That little fan's still going, so we gotta add water to this. And it's 68 in the house. I took that before I came down. So yeah, not too bad. And it's what, 12 degrees outside? Now what I like to do is I open this door. You just crack it for a little bit, slowly open it. Pull my bucket over. Then we're gonna take out this little bit of ash in the front. And when you set it down in the bucket, if you set it like this at an angle, it slowly goes backwards, then it doesn't leave, you don't see it just go all up in the air. We're gonna pull all this to the front. Same thing as this morning. We're gonna add some kindling, only I'm gonna do a little different because it's 68 in the house. I'm gonna heat up the house quick. So I'll show you what I do there. Got a flame going.
So now that it's going like that, open this up. And this is when I like to burn the awkward wood.
So what I mean by awkward wood is, like, look at this big chunk with the big knot on it. This is when I like to burn. Set this in there. We're gonna set it north to south because we want heat fast. So by going north to south, it's gonna give you the heat. I'm gonna take another piece, throw it in there. And you wanna pack this kinda loosely to get air in there so it starts it up and it goes quick. That's the whole point of north to south. I'll do this, and this will only be a couple hours, and I'll show you. And then basically the next load after that, if the house is in the 70s, I'll load it like I did this morning, and then it'll go all night. Then you want to go east to west. But these three logs, this might be done, you know, depending on the wood, I guess. This might be done here in a little while. And that's it. So basically, if you had time in the morning, you could do a quick load like that just to give a burst of heat in the morning, and then stack it from east to west, and then you're good to go. Pretty simple. Once you figure out your wood stove and get a feel of it, you'll know where the air control is. Every wood stove is different. Mine is about, you go all the way down, and when I want to burn fast, it's a quarter inch open. Otherwise, it's about an eighth to maybe 3/16. And that little bit of a three, or even from a 16th, from 3/16 to a quarter, is a ton of a difference for how much the stove heats up. So just an FYI. But get a feel of your stove. Don't be scared of it. Just use common sense. Hope this helps. Glad you guys see me again. Bye.